There are different types of economies in today's world. A pure market economy, also known as laissez-faire capitalism, is an economy in which individual households and firms determine the allocation of resources and the government plays an extremely limited role, primarily in enforcing property rights through a legal system and providing for a common defense. A centrally planned economy, also known as a command economy, is one in which a single individual or small group of individuals determines the allocation of resources, and individual firms and households have little say over what is produced, how goods are produced, and the distribution of these goods. A mixed economy is one in which government plays a more active role in the market process, including regulation, standardization, taxation, and income redistribution. Households and firms still have some control over what is produced, how goods are produced, and the distribution of those goods. However, the government also influences these decisions. A market is a mechanism that facilitates the exchange of specific scarce resource amongst competing agents. There are two major types of markets. A. Goods markets, in which services and finished goods are exchanged, and B. Factor markets, in which factors of production, that is, the things used to produce other goods and services, are exchanged. A good is anything deemed desirable by the agents in the economy, e.g., soda, pizza, Porsches, running water, or a lack of pollution. Factors of production are items used to produce goods and services. There are three major factors of production: land, all natural resources, gold, coal, plutonium, etc., and the like; labor, effort, mental and physical, of human beings; capital, all equipment, tools, factories, and goods used in production. Thus far, the terms introduced are part of the basic language of economics. Once these and similar definitions are understood, economists can talk to each other with little difficulty. However, it is valuable to also delineate general areas of focus within the overall field of economics. In general, there are two major branches of economics. Microeconomics is the study of individual markets, how individual agents interact within those markets, and how individual economic agents make decisions. Macroeconomics is the study of national and global economic activity. To many, this distinction seems relatively semantic. After all, you can't have the macroeconomy, that is a national economy, without the microeconomy, that is individual economic agents. While this is true, the areas of focus are somewhat exclusive to each field, although many economists would argue this point. Macroeconomists focus on general time trends at the national or perhaps regional level. These issues would include the overall unemployment rate, overall interest rates, and whether the national income of a country is increasing or decreasing, although this list is by no means exhaustive. On the other hand, microeconomists would perhaps investigate the unemployment rate in a particular industry, or the number of employees hired by a particular firm, or whether a firm will purchase new technology at prevailing interest rates. Notice the subtle difference in the level of focus between the two areas. Macroeconomics is akin to astronomy, or the study of the universe as a whole, whereas microeconomics is akin to molecular chemistry, or the understanding of how the basic building blocks of the universe operate. While the tools of the trade can often be considered dry, just like the tools of any trade, economists shouldn't not be seen as typical brethrens, who lacks any form of compassion and are likely to go into too many factual details, embodied in the cliché that economists know the prices of everything and the value of nothing. This is not the case, and some of the most heated and interesting debates in economics center on our concern over value rather than price. Economists are humans and enjoy the same range of emotion as others, even if economists are quick to point out, on the other hand, the perception that economists are too factual is the consequence of confusion between positive economics, which is the study of what is, and normative economics, which is the study of what should be. Positive economics addresses questions such as what is unemployment, whereas normative economics addresses questions such as what should the government do about unemployment. The first question is in the spirit of just the facts, ma'am, whereas the second question is more philosophical and, usually, controversial. Again, the distinction might seem semantic to many people, but it gets to the heart of economic analysis. Economists are deeply concerned with many things, including how to foster economic development in third world countries, how to reduce criminal activity in the inner city, and how best to fund public goods such as national defense and road construction. However, before the question of what should be done about a particular problem, it is first necessary to understand the facts of the problem. Hence, economists often focus first on the positive and then on the normative. Both positive and normative statements are tested using economic theories, which are generally based on an economic model. An economic model is a simplified view of reality. Because it is very difficult to capture all of the aspects of reality in a model, we simplify our view of reality to focus on the particular question being asked. An economic model is comprised of two parts, assumptions and implications. The assumptions are simplifications of reality and are valid only within the context.